Good morning. Welcome back. Now, over the past few months, we've been bringing you various ways you can invest the money you currently have to work for your future.
Now, everyone who invests wants to put their money where it will grow the most. But while investments with the highest returns are attractive, they also are the most risky.
So today on Financial Freedom Minutes, our resident money man, Yap Ming Hui, will take us through three types of investments which promise high return and what strategies to apply when dealing with these investments.
Mm-hmm. Over to you, Mr. Yap.
Good morning. Good morning, fellow Malaysian. You are now watching Financial Freedom Minutes with Yap Ming Hui. Today, I'm going to talk about high return investment. Okay? So what do I mean by high return investment? Basically, high return investment is those investments that promise to give you a return or will generate a return of at least 12% a year. Okay? So I know you're getting very excited already, but don't get too excited. Because why? High return means also high risk. Because when there's actually no risk, no gain. So the risk of investing in this high return investment is always there. The question is whether it's obvious to you or not. So today, I will share three examples of high return investment. What are the risks and how you can manage those risks and invest into it. Now, number one investment I want to share with you is what I call gold bar investing scheme. I got a friend who actually invested in gold bar investing scheme, whereby actually give him an investment return of 1% per month, which is 12% per year, and with a gold bar in hand. Which means when he invested 100,000, he'll be given 100,000 worth of gold bar plus 1% return per month. That sounds good, isn't it? So then what's the catch? The catch is that after 1 year of investing and receiving 12% return, the company asked him to go back to renew the whole scheme. So he obediently brought back all the gold bar to the company and leave the gold bar for inspection and all the paperwork. 3 days later, when he's supposed to go there to collect the gold bar, he found there's nobody there in the office anymore. Everybody run away. The whole company run away with the gold bar already. So it seems to say at the end, you may actually enjoy 12% return, but the capital of 100,000 that you with the gold bar is gone. So be aware of such a risk. Be very careful of whatever capital you have in your hand. Next, I want to share about hedge fund investment. This hedge fund investment, mother of my friend actually invested in this hedge fund, which is offered from an island called British Virgin Island, if you ever heard about that island. And they promised to pay 2% return per month, and they have got a track record of paying for past 5 years. So 2% per month, it means 24% a year. That's don't know how many times of the fixed deposit interest that you get. Good, huh? So it sounds also very good. The only problem that you need to be aware of two risks that you have. Number one is that a lot of time when you invest in a hedge fund like that, operating from this kind of offshore havens, you do not know how do they operate to generate the return. So for example, when my friend actually asked this salesperson to explain to him how do they manage to generate 2% per month to give to them, the salesperson can't even explain what do they invest into in order to generate this 2% return. So when they can't explain to that, you need to be very careful. Okay. And next, because there are chances that it could be a Ponzi scheme. Now, the second problem that we have is that under hedge fund, there's no proper regulation. Okay. So when there's no regulation, should something go wrong with the fund, they lost money, they can close down the company and you can't find the company and your money anymore. So sure enough, in the year 2008, whereby the fund suffered a lot of losses, they practically closed out the company and the mother of my friend can't even locate them and actually find the money back. Third example I want to share today is land banking. I'm sure quite a number of you heard about land banking offer for you to invest in a land plot, maybe in US, UK, Canada, blah, blah, blah. So basically, this investment talk about investing in some plot of land there, they'll further develop to generate a return of maybe 16% a year, which sounds also very good. But the question is, when we want to invest in the land banking investment, two questions that we need to be very mindful of. Number one, when you invest in property or land, very important is the location. Location, location, and locations. So when it's so far away in Canada, UK, you don't even know where exactly is location. I have a friend who actually invested into a UK kind of land banking, then later discovered that the land that he actually bought actually is a land reserved for kind of environment protections by the government. So which means to say that land can never be developed into higher capital appreciation at all. So take note of that. And next is the distance. Now, the fact that UK, US so far from Malaysia, should everything go well smoothly, of course, you can actually happily get the money bank into your bank account. But the question is that if something go wrong with the investment, then how are you going to actually go to US, go to the this government department to complain about getting your money back and things like that? Plus also, because the tax, the law is different, you need to be very mindful. So last but not least, I want to share what should be the proper investing strategy that you should have when you want to invest into this kind of high return investment. Now, number one, I think we need to remember that there's no free lunch in this world. So we need to actually ask them, how do they generate this return for you? So we need to understand, we need to get the person who is supposed to sell it to you to explain how do they, what do they invest and how do they manage to generate the promised return to you. Okay? And you need to make sure that you understand whether that can actually possibly be done. So just don't just be like greedy and then buy whatever they say. And remember what Warren Buffett said, never invest into anything that you do not understand completely. Okay? Second thing, find out what happened to your money if the company go bust or the company go under. So we must actually prepare for the worst situation, because when we invest, we don't look at not only the return on your investment, but the return of your investment capital as well. So you need to ask, if the company were to go bust, what will happen, and is there any authority would actually have to protect your interest? Last, if you really cannot resist this temptation of high return, I would caution you to always limit your investment into this kind of scheme to not more than 5% of total investable asset. Which means to say, if you were to have like a 1 million worth of asset, like cash, share, unit trust and property, invest not more than 50,000 in this investment. So should this investment give a good return, congratulations. But if it were to go bust, at least you don't lose all of your hard-earned money. So this is what I share today. And always remember, every one of us can achieve financial freedom. So talk to a financial independent financial advisor to optimize the money that you have. So back to you, Joanne and Hanson.
Thank you, Mr. Yap.
You describe, you know, some of the options for high investment. Sounds like
high return.
High returns, yeah. High return investments. It sounds like they're all scams. Sounds like they're all scams. But is it like, you know, that could be just a particular company, but is all these type of investments all scams then?
Okay, let me qualify. Not all these three types of investment actually are scam.
Right. Mm.
For example, hedge fund. There are some genuine hedge fund. They are big. They are properly registered. Some of them even actually listed in the stock exchange.
Okay.
Right. So these are the more genuine ones. So should something go wrong, at least you know where to look for.
How would you identify a legitimate hedge fund?
Yeah, so that's why, very importantly, is that when you receive a hedge fund proposal, mm-hmm. you need to ask what's the company.
Okay.
So where are they registered?
Okay.
Where are they regulated?
Right.
Now, what's the holding company?
Right.
So are they established and strong?
Mm-hmm.
And normally, they also say that they have like capital guarantee protection by another bank.
Mm-hmm.
So which are the bank? Mm-hmm. If they are offered by another sound bank, major bank in Australia, Singapore, then of course you feel very confident.
Okay.
Right.
But if they guarantee by the bank whereby you never hear before.
So, like some island country somewhere.
Yeah, some island country somewhere. You better check further to make sure that it's properly registered. So all these investment, not all of them are scam.
Mm.
There are some good ones, but there are some maybe a scam.
Okay. But the ones that's more difficult to tell are the gold bar investment schemes, because really, how do you tell a fake from a real investment scheme when it comes to gold bars?
And this gold bar investment has been around for a long time.
Yes.
And it started, I believe, with those gold coins.
Gold coins.
Yeah.
Yes. So you, just as I think Asians, Chinese, Indian, Malaysia, we like to have gold. Right?
Yeah.
We love gold.
So the issue is that, again, it become go back to the provider.
Mm.
Like for example, it's like a Malaysia bank. You know, I can name the name, P Bank, M Bank,
right.
You know, all these kind of bank which actually offer this kind of gold coin or gold bar or gold bullion investing.
Mm.
That one actually may be something more legitimate.
Mm.
You know? But then again, they may not promise you 1% return per month and things like that.
Yeah,
you know? What you can notice is that normally those kind of scheme is that when you invest, so you invest 10,000, you get 10,000 more for gold.
Yeah.
Normally that's it.
Yeah.
Gold price go up, you actually gain.
Yeah,
but here, notice the one I shared just now, not only you're getting gold, but they guarantee you 1% return per month.
Yeah.
Right,
which is coming from where?
As you said, too good to be true.
Too good to be
true. So if something does happen and, these people you have invested your money with do run away and close shop.
Yes.
What can a person do?
That's why I say I would suggest that when you want to actually prevent things from happening, I think you should actually do it at the very beginning, before you invest the money. So it does not hurt you to ask a few more questions.
Yeah.
It does not hurt you to really ask a few friends of yours or even check with some independent financial advisor before you put your hard-earned money into it.
Yeah.
Because I got a friend who actually invested into the UK kind of land banking investment. Yeah. At the end, the company in the UK go bust. So then you go into all the legal tussle then, and now that, even though I'm actually advising, there's nothing much I can help him to do.
Right. Yeah. The authorities here can't do much because
we cannot help you to do it.
And one thing I noticed, a lot of people who are trying to do now are actually trying to get people to invest via the telephone. So, and one thing I always do is I'm like, don't speak to me. I say, send me documentation. And if they can't send you documentation, then, you know, it's probably a fraud.
Yes. So that's why when you actually when you act as a smart consumer, ask a few more questions, that normally will put some roadblock or barriers to these people who try to sell you something. So this scheme never end, okay? And also we always find investors investing into it. But I think I hope that through this project or this program, the consumer can be better educated.
Right.
More informed, ask smart questions.
But again, I mean, again, as we want to reiterate that not all of these type of investments are scams. There are legit ones out there.
Exactly. For example, Hanson, you said a few of your friends are actually investing in land banking.
Oh yeah, I mean, there's a big company, and you know, that's I think they do land banking in Canada, and I think that one's, you know, it's pretty big and a lot of people investing in that. So I mean, it could be a legit one. But again, I think it's not just the company. Also, I think you've just got to pick, like you say, because it's high returns.
Yes.
So there's also high risk involved. So even if you lose money, it might not be the company. It's just that maybe you bought a plot of land that wasn't, you know, very viable.
Effectively, and then to get a better return. So that's why, let's assume a case that this high return investment that we mentioned just now, a proper land banking investment that you go into, a proper company, properly registered, everything is there.
But there's still risk.
But there's still the risk there, you know, because the risk comes from where? The risk comes from the fact that you are putting the money into the land far in Canada, and which whereby if you put the money in Malaysia, you say, for example, you're going to buy a land in a kampong. Something go wrong, you can go to the land office, you can go and check, you know where to find a lawyer.
Yeah.
You know? But if something go wrong in Canada, what can you do? You can practically say that comparing the hassle of me going to Canada and go and make a complaint, I'd rather like
just write it off.
So, okay, to wrap things up, are we saying to our viewers to be slightly wary of higher return investments?
I would say that there's no free lunch in this world.
Right.
We get to be not only slightly wary, but very, very cautious.
Very wary.
Very, very cautious.
Very, very cautious.
Okay. We're going to leave it up to you to read between the lines. But if you do have any follow-up questions regarding this week's topic, if you're planning to make any major financial decisions, you can always email Mr. Yap at inquiries@yapminghui.com. You can even send him an SMS at 012-39-00048.
Or you could just visit his website, www.yapminghui.com, for all the information you need. Anyway, thank you very much, Mr. Yap. We'll see you next Tuesday.